A tool that is going to be fundamental in our day-to-day work in Mistika, especially when we're color grading, but it also is going to be very useful for other operations, is going to be the storyboard. And right now I'm in the visual editor and we can't see the storyboard because I have to turn it on, and I have two options. I have split, where I can see, in this case, a single line, or full, where it will go almost full screen. To do my work, I normally always work in split. And from here, you have different options. You can add more lines, and you can change the zoom factor of the clips. So depending on how you want to work, you can choose different options. In this case, I normally work with zoom factor 2 and just in one line. Under the zoom options, we have different options that are going to modify how the storyboard will interact with the user and how it will behave. What we're going to look at first is the options of scroll and lock. Basically, what is going to happen, I'm going to choose scroll right now, is we're going to define how the storyboard is going to move when we go from one shot to the next. Obviously, those who have control panels and dedicated buttons to do these operations, it will be slightly more intuitive. For those that only have a keyboard, to go to the next shot would be just control right arrow. So there we go. And you can see that as soon as I move out of the first set of icons or shots that was shown in my storyboard, the storyboard scrolls to the next shot, or the previous shot in this case. Okay, I normally prefer to work in centered. So if I go, I would say center current, okay, and that centers the storyboard to the current shot I'm working in, okay. And if I set lock current, it will lock the position of the storyboard to that of the current shot. So now if I go to the next shot, you could see that the white frame that represents the current shot remains in the center. Same thing applies to the selected shot, and the selected shot is represented by the red frame. In this case, now I have current and selected shot in the same shot. So if I choose scroll selected here, and I go to my bring menu, which is going to move the selected shot in my storyboard, and go to the previous clip, you could see that it will, as soon as we get out of the first few shots that were shown in the storyboard, it will start scrolling the selection. Okay, so, and scrolling the storyboard to the selection. So that is one thing to take into account when we do this. So another way of selecting a shot easily and fast with the mouse would be just by clicking. Okay, so for example, I click on that shot that is two next shots later. So you could see that in this red frame, I have the word snapshot written at the bottom. That is because in my storyboard menu, I have the auto snapshot option activated. And this comes in handy when you want to compare shots, or you want to basically show a split screen. you have the option of, as soon as you make a selection, you will have automatically that split screen created. So you can see that as soon as I click, you can compare it with the current shot because the snapshot is automatically made. Also, another thing I didn't mention is that, as with other elements and windows in Mistika, you can move the storyboard with the right button of the mouse. Okay, so you could do that just exactly as in the timeline. I'm gonna turn off the snapshot and show just live. Okay, and there's one more thing I want to mention, and it's, you can see here that in my current shot I have the word head B written down in green. I'm going to change that because I'm going to set lock head B. What that is going to do is lock a second playhead, it's a virtual playhead, to the selection I have. So if I go three shots back, automatically the head B moves to that shot. If I go to the shot that I was using to after, it will automatically go there. What is this helpful for? Well, if I go to my bring menu, and in the control panels you would also have the swap playheads option. You could go and click swap playheads and automatically jump between the selection and the current shot. You could use this to compare grades, or you could use this to actually copy grades, as we're going to do now. I'm going to go to this shot, and now I'm going to show you two ways of copying a grade. First, you could double click, and that will copy the grade automatically. If you're not convinced, you can go to the bring menu and say just bring the original, okay, because it's actually what I wanted. Or the other option, if you are not sure that this is the grade you want to apply, if you click with the left button for a few seconds, it will momentarily copy the grade. If you release, it goes back to the original shot, where's original grade with no grade. And if you're convinced by it, you can click with the left mouse, and just a quick small gesture upwards, you could apply the grade. Okay, so these are the different options with the storyboard, and just one more thing, you could also flush icons and create all icons when necessary. And another thing is also the lock offset. What lock offset will do, especially in grades where there is a 1-2 conversation, two people speaking, it might be useful to have the offset of the selection and the current shot locked so you can copy grade easily. So that is a general overview of how you can configure the storyboard, and in later videos we could see some more features.